Doctors want for Christmas are masks, warning it's time to cover up in public gatherings, hospitals and flights amid the nation's eighth COVID wave. Let's bring in today medical expert Dr. Nick Coatsworth in Canberra. Doc, good morning to you. Is it really necessary?
Carlos, if masks work at all, they only work when you wear them in all situations as part of a suite of measures, including social distancing and movement restrictions, which I can assure you we're not going back to. Now, the AMA's quoted 245 hospitalisations with COVID in this wave in Queensland, but I want to remind our viewers that there are over 1 million admissions to Queensland hospitals every year. So the suggestion that this is a wave is probably incorrect. We don't need to go back to masks, and we need to remind ourselves that the Australian Medical Association is a political lobby group, not a group of infectious
disease physicians. Okay, you need to expand on that, because I couldn't agree with you more. And I think, you know, when you talk about waves, the language around all this can sometimes get fanned. It's not right.
That's right, Carl. Let's reassure the public that vaccination works, that COVID is now a milder disease because of what we call herd immunity. We've all been exposed to it. And there are other ways to manage the hospital pressures. Here in Canberra, we use virtual care clinics. We used hospital in the homes. And frankly, I was on shift yesterday and we had not a single patient with COVID in our acute medical unit. So I don't think that it's the disaster that's sometimes made out to be. And we need to listen to the right people, public health physicians, infectious disease physicians, rather than the AMA.
Hear, hear. Meantime, only 1 in 8 Aussie GPs are now bulk billing patients, charging private fees of around $75 compared to $64 last year. We also are hearing that 1 in 3 GPs want to quit in the next 5 years. How concerned are you about all of that?
Well, I'm deeply concerned, Carl, and for a couple of reasons. I think the first one is for the patients of Australia that need primary care that's affordable. Now, we just had a $3.5 billion injection by the government in what the College of General Practitioners said would be a game changer. So where's the game change? We should see more Australians being bulk billed now. Now, as to the attractiveness of general practice, I want to say to all the medical students and young doctors out there, this is an attractive and important thing that you can do for your community by being a primary care physician. There is nothing better than a good general practitioner. We just need more of them, and we're working hard to remunerate them better. But I think we need to see them come to the party with increasing those bulk billing rates.
Good to talk to you, Doc. Appreciate it, Sarah.
Let's now turn to Queensland's new COVID alert. People are being asked to mask up once again at public gatherings, hospitals and on flights by doctors as Australia's eighth wave hits the state hard. Today, Queensland reporter Andrea Crothers joins us now from Brisbane. Andrea, the health system is already under pressure.
Yeah, that's according to the Australian Medical Association of Queensland. So it's the one who's behind this push for us to mask up, saying there's 245 hospitalisations in Queensland due to COVID, and it's already putting the system under pressure. But we know masks were controversial even at the height of COVID. So what do Queenslanders think about this idea?
Whatever's best for the well-being of everyone else.
Yeah, I reckon maybe we should wear masks if we've got some sort of sickness.
There's too much COVID out and about again, and we should all mask up or risk Christmas. What do you reckon?
Risk Christmas. Yeah. Don't wear a mask.
Yeah, it seems most people agree. There's only been one person wearing a mask here at Central Station this morning in Brisbane. In terms of what restrictions are in place, there are none in Queensland. It's up to individual health and hospital services if they want people to mask up, Jane.
Andrew, thank you.